just because you think you're so hot, just because you think you got something that nobody else has got. You cost me a strand on my body, you locked all your static body. I'm telling you, baby, I'm through with you, just because.
How many Slovenian friends do we have here tonight? All right. How many Canadians do we have here tonight? All right. Here's the first song my mother taught me, one called the Silk Umbrella Polka. It's actually the first song that Frankie Yankovic ever recorded. Okay? The Silk Umbrella Polka, and she sang it to me, and I learned it. Yes, Pati, Pajida na Marela. Right, Tony? Tony Krasovic and all our friends. One, two, three.
Yes, Patty,
A nice round of applause for Eddie Brewster. Thank you. Amen. One of the finest puppy box players I have ever heard, I'm telling you. Not only that, but he's a smart guy in school, too. Yeah, he's one of those professors. A Slovenian professor, that's really something, I'll tell you. And you'll have a chance to see if this is tomorrow. What time? 7 o'clock, and the Gerkmans are on when? 5 o'clock. So see the Gerkmans, by God, you're going to hear a lot of good Slovenian tunes, and I mean that. We love them. You're a wonderful family.
Hey, you were our
age. Old Ronnie?
Well, yeah, dude, if he was that small.
Just remember one thing. If I'm old, you're right there with me.
That's right. At the end of the night, Mark and Aaron go home. Walter goes to the home.
Time right now. Norm, we're going to do what I call Across the Plains, all right?
Oh, you got it.
I automatically fell in love with this tune, and when we were going to record an album, I said, can I please sing this? And
so we're going to do it for you. This is our version of the Painter Polka, or Hoo La La La, Feel Free to Sing Along. What?
Thank you.
Anyway, it's been a pleasure working with Mark Light and my brother-in-law, John Pogolko. His favorite tune, one of his favorite tunes is Schultz's Polka. You want to do that one for him?
Okay. What do you
have? You're going to count it in there.
Thank you.
I'm just a jerk. West Bay Walsh. Gee, one, two, three, cut, two.
Thank you.
1956. Does anybody here know who Ray Price is? I really don't believe they've written a good country song since 1960. I'm living in a town of Oakland and I'm darn proud of it. We're going to take you back to 1956, and here's a Ray Price tune called My Shoes Keep Walking Back to You. If you keep track of this, it's in the key your drums kicks off to the five, which is a D. One!
Thank you.
when he's 77 years old. 77 years young, ladies and gentlemen, Norm Polka on the saxophone.
Bye. industry has been behind the times.
It's polka time.
Canada's king of polka. It's been three decades of playing and promoting polka, and Walter Ostanek doesn't give up. He made the Polka Hall of Fame, and he appeared on the Johnny Carson Show.
A pot of gold, a pot of gold, fell in my arms, fell in my arms, as I embraced your rainbow side.
But for those who aren't polka fans, Walter is best known as this. Popular SCTV skit, The Schmengi Brothers, is based on Walter Ostanek.
Two, three, four.
But Walter Ostanek takes his polka seriously, and last night his love for polka was awarded with a Grammy.
Well, we managed to catch up with Walter Ostanek today at the Los Angeles airport just before he jumps on his plane to come home. Mr. Ostanek, let's start by saying congratulations. You must be really excited.
Oh, I tell you, I'm flying without the airplane.
What made the difference this time? You've been working at this for 30 years. You've got 43 recordings. You've been up for Grammys before. How come it worked in 93?
Well, I have been working hard at it just a little bit more every year. I have met more people in the business. I belong to the Nashville chapter. I've been there every time when I'm nominated. They always have pre-Grammy parties, and I make sure that I go there. And you meet a lot of people in our industry, and that's what it's all about. It's promotion, and promotion as far as radio is concerned and DJs, and I have been working hard every year, and I guess just it mounts up, and this year probably maybe has something to do with NARIS, the Grammy celebrating their 35th anniversary, and I do have a 35th wedding anniversary, and I've been a band leader for 35 years as well. So
it was all in the stars.
Yes, it's like Garth Brooks, he has the unanswered prayer. I've been there, this was my fifth time nominated, and I guess my prayer was answered, and I'm very, very happy about it.
Well, that's great. Now, some of us actually know and love the polka. I grew up in a small town, but for the uninitiated, how would you explain it?
Well, polkas are very, very happy music. When you come to a polka dance, you forget your troubles.
Now, polka sometimes gets a bit of a bad rap. I'm sure you know about the Schmengi brothers and John Candy and all of that. Do you think that it isn't treated with respect?
No. John Candy, when I first seen the movie, I wasn't very happy about it. But I've changed my attitude. It's in other words, I take a different perspective now. And I also am a real John Candy fan. Matter of fact, I'm wishing that I'm going to meet him personally one of these days soon.
So it's all part of the PR, of the public relations.
You have to take it with a grain of salt. And like I say, if you believe in something, there's a lot of people out there that do believe in what we're doing. And I believe in it, have believed in it since day one.
Now, you say that actually the golden age of polka was between the mid-40s and the mid-70s, and you're kind of waiting for a comeback. Do you think it's coming back soon?
Well, Frankie Yankovic, America's Polka King, he had it all started after the war, and he was very successful. He had 2 million sellers with Just Because and the Blue Skirt Waltz, and he sold millions of records and traveled all over the world and appeared on every national television show. And in the 40s and 50s, probably CBC was playing the odd polka during the day. This is not so today, but I see the accordion coming back. For example, accordion is with polka music, and Blue Rodeo has an accordion player that plays keyboards and accordion. Also, last night, K.D. Lang, she has a regular accordion player in the band now.
Well, you're Canada's undisputed polka king now. You've always been famous, Mr. Ostanek. Are you going to be rich now?
Well, I'll tell you what, I want to be healthy first, and that's always my number one goal, health for myself, my family, and everyone in the world, and then I'll take what what it brings, but I will do my best to try and stay in this business because I love it from the bottom of my heart.
Well, keep playing and keep dancing. Thanks very much.
Thank you for having me.
Mr. Walter Ostanek, Canada's Polka King, he finally won a Grammy last night in Los Angeles. Stay with us. We'll be back after this with more of Prime Time.
Viewers, and he was nominated, I was going to just say he was nominated many times, but this is the first time
he
actually gets one, which is nice to see. First, though, Nancy McKellar has all the latest entertainment news. The girl for Whitney Houston. Houston is the proud mother of his Polka King. Walter Ostanek says he wants to share his Grammy Award with his fans. After 5 years of being nominated, Ostanek was finally victorious. Once he receives his Grammy trophy, it's going on display in his music store in St. Catharines. Ostanek believes winning the music industry's most coveted prize will breathe new life into his career.
With the economic times, the way things are, and the change in music, I think that probably it's going to get the Walter Ostanek a little more motivated again, and maybe get my act together again with the boys, and maybe get a little more excited and go out there and play a few extra jobs.
Walter Ostanek will be featured this weekend on CKCO's Province Wide Sunday at 6:30. And a number of Canadians were in the running, Katie Lang and Celine Dion to name a few, and one often overlooked Canadian musician, Walter Ostanek, who's been nominated 5 times in the polka category. He thought a Canadian just couldn't do it, but he was wrong. Canada's King of Polka walked away with the award this year. We went to his hometown of St. Catharines, Ontario, to hear about the victory.
Walter Ostanek is a man looking for a bit of respect.
It's polka time with Canada's King of Polka, Walter Ostanek, and his show band.
After 35 years of cranking away on the squeeze box, the undisputed Polka King of Canada is finally getting it. For 17 years, Walter and his merry show band hosted this program that served up a weekly assortment of lively polka tunes. They were even spoofed by comedians John Candy and Joe Levy.
And you're watching CKCO TV,
your Oktoberfest station. Prost!
And although Walter's polka fans are somewhat mature, they're fiercely loyal. It's that support that's kept him in the business for 35 years. And now Walter has finally reached the pinnacle of every musician's dream. He's just back from winning a Grammy Award in the polka category. Nominated 5 times, it's his first time winning. At the music store he and his family own in St. Catharines, Ontario, friends are waiting to congratulate him.
My good buddies here are Andy Spinoza and Helen and Uncle John.
Walter.
How you doing, buddy?
Howdy, Walter.
All right.
You did a good job.
You know, you can only win it again. I'm getting sentimental here. You can only win it again, but it's not like the first one. Once you win the first one, that's it. You are a Grammy winner, and you'll be a Grammy winner forever.
On the night of the Grammys, this is what television viewers saw.
Eric Clapton and Will Jennings, songwriters.
The live telecast was reserved for the more popular musical forms, like pop and country. Fans back in Canada learned about Walter's victory this way. A brief mention during the show with a freeze frame shot taken earlier. But Walter says it was a sweet moment he's waited a long time to savor. His arch competitor, American polka star Jimmy Sturr, was featured on the day of the Grammys in a tabloid newspaper. The article claims Sturr was a shoe-in for his 7th straight Grammy. Walter says he was biting his nails.
So when we went to the Grammys on Wednesday, I told my wife, I says, Irene, I'm not going to win. I mean, I did my best, but I'm not going to be a winner today. So what I'm going to do is psych myself away from being a winner, because when it hits me, it won't hit me so bad, because otherwise, I really put a lot of effort into it this year.
And this is the recording that clinched it. It's titled Walter Ostanek's 35th Anniversary. When his category came up, Walter says he was so nervous, he doesn't even remember who read his name.
So he opened it up. I know it was a fella. He opened it up. And he says, the winner is, now in my back of my mind I can hear, 35th anniversary, and it didn't ring a bell until he mentioned my name. And then all of a sudden it was just like as if somebody hit me with a sledgehammer. I couldn't, it's like, I just couldn't believe it, you know, and I broke down, and my wife gives me a hug and a kiss, and the next guy, the Dick Taddy, gives me a hug and a kiss, and then the rest has been like, Neverland.
And with that one moment of victory, things haven't been the same. Walter says the phone hasn't stopped ringing. The media is making this 58-year-old feel like an overnight celebrity. He even got a mention on a late-night talk show.
And finally, the award we've all been waiting for, Best Polka Album.
The nominees are Eddie Blazancic's Versatones, Lenny Gomolka in the Chicago Push, and Walter Ostanek.
And the Grammy for Best Polka Album goes to this unbelievable Eric Clapton. Once again, Eric Clapton.
The past week has also been a time of reflection for Walter Ostanek. In the basement of his music store, he took us into the accordion room, where over 170 of these instruments lay in waiting to ring out their distinctive sound. Accordions have been called everything from squeeze box to the stomach Steinway. They're like the Rodney Dangerfield of musical instruments. They get no respect. But to Walter, the sound they make is pure magic. He was 9 years old when he got his first button accordion. His Slovenian parents knew that young Walter wanted to play.
We were at a party one Sunday afternoon on the outskirts of St. Catharines, and my father came up to me and he said, Walter, he says, called me Lado. He says, Lado, you still want that accordion? I says, yes, Dad. Ata, I used to call him Ata. He says, well, you got one. I just bought one for you for $75.
3 years later, Walter got his first piano accordion. By the age of 16, he says he'd formed his first band with some school friends. And a year later, things got serious when he set his eyes on this beauty, an American-made Bell accordion. It set him back $1,700. That was a lot of money back in 1952. Walter says it has that special bite, a singing sound that he looks for in a good polka-playing accordion. Over the years, Walter has played countless one-night stands in smoke-filled dance halls. The one song that fans request over and over again is the Beer Barrel Polka. But Walter says he has his own favorites.
There's all kinds of polkas, and you can get a little fancy. I'm a little out of shape in the last couple of weeks, no playing.
There's something infectious about this music. It's bouncy beat. It's eternal happiness, like the smile that seems to permanently radiate from Walter's face. He's always smiling. A local newspaper captured him in the quintessential caricature. Look closely, that's an accordion in Walter's mouth. That picture is one of many in a shrine to the Polka King's career.
This is my first album. This album was recorded around 1960, 62 or 63, a gay continental dance party. This is the picture that we used during our television series on CKCO.
And the pride of his collection is five Grammy nominations.
These are the actual diplomas that you get for the years
for having been nominated.
Once he receives his Grammy trophy, Walter says he's going to put it on display in the music store so anyone can come in and have a look at it. He says he owes a great debt to his wife Irene and his son and daughter for their moral support over the years. They always stood behind him on his rocky road to success. And as for the future, Walter says winning the Grammy will breathe new life into his career. He's just recorded a new album with his all-time hero, polka great Frankie Yankovic. And so long as fans keep dancing, he'll keep playing.
The end.
Do you have anything you want to say about our program tonight? Have a pen and some paper on hand. Our mail segment is...
We're going to send this next song out to all the people who... A long time ago in his dad's, well, the basement of his dad's hardware store. And he dedicated it to his dad. We're going to send it out to all of you. Here's Andy's Jolly Hop Polka. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the man who wrote Andy's Jolly Hop, that Grammy Award winner, America's Polka King, a big Canadian welcome for Frankie Yankovic.
Hey, little sweetheart, how do you do? I'd like to spend all my days with you. Tell me you're mine and I'll guarantee we'll be as happy as can be. And when we're married, we'll build a home with love and laughter for us alone. And then, of course, dear, a family, we'll be as happy as can be. Happy as can be.
and feel welcome, if you would. Here's Sean Greeley and one.
Here's the Page Polka. I'm afraid we're in that same situation. The good news, bad news. Bad news is we're out of time. Good news is same time, same station next week. From Polka Time, goodbye, everybody.
any time you pass through western Newfoundland. There's a river and a highway and the train runs to and fro. A face upon the mountain gazes down on those below. There's an island in the river and the town is going around. It's been printed by a paper in a neighboring little town that a pirate buried treasure there so very long ago. That face upon the mountain is the only one who knows. Ever got there is a story no one knows. Is it one of nature's wonders? Was it man-made long ago? Was it carved upon the mountain by a pirate's skillful hand to forever guard his treasure buried in that island sand? If that face could only talk and all the stories it could tell of the many things it's witnessed from that high majestic hill, of the many tragic accidents on the road and water too, that has happened through the years there in that face of stony you. There it stands upon the mountain in the twilight's shimmering haze, mid storms of wind and thunder with its death-defying gaze. And when our life is ended and the master makes his call, that face upon the mountain, well, be there to see it all.
Welcome back to Polka Time. I know, as you heard, Frankie Yankovic's going to be on the show very shortly, but this man is very special, too. He's the producer of Frankie's Grammy-winning album. Here's Joey Miskulin and Valley Spring. Thanks, Joey. This next song we're going to send out to all the very good polka time will take care of them, we guarantee it. Going to keep everybody up on the dance floor now for the Rolling Rock Polka. The next song is called The Blue Skirt Waltz. The man I'm sure you all know, currently a Grammy Award winner and America's Polka King. Nice warm round of applause for Frankie Yankovic.
I dream of that night with you, lady, when first we met. We dance in the world. How can my heart forget? Bluer skies and bluer your eyes, just like the blue skirt you wore. Come back, blue lady, come back. Don't be blue anymore. Just like the blue skirt you wore.
polka time, everybody. You've had enough chance to relax. Come on up on the dance floor and join us with the band on Rosalinda. Well, ladies and gentlemen, as we continue on Polka Time, this next song coming up is something extra special. You know, at Polka Time, we always try and do something interesting and unique. This particular song is, well, I'll let you see for yourself. It requires not only special talent, but special musical instruments, too. You'll see on the Chicagoland Twirl.
Thank you.
Well, I guess that's what happens when you spend too much time on the road. Start going to pieces. We better get out of here before the rest of the band falls apart. As always, it's been a pleasure on Polka Time. See you again next week. Bye now.